I never dared to break the seal on this scroll, though I often wanted to. I found it in a dust-covered box with a label marked Maps of Southron Trade Routes. Berenor is a Haradrim, so perhaps this scroll has a map of his homeland. Breaking the seal is strictly forbidden for those who aren't Lords of Gondor, and as much as I'm curious, I know my father would not approve.
your command, my lord! Command, my lord!
Hark.
Be sticking your arm near them. I've been starving them for days.
Look at those poor beasts in cages. If you love something, set it free, I say. Who's with me?
You there! Honestly, Korth, I'm amazed you're still alive. But I won't be amazed much longer.
From your teeth!
I don't want to burn! Fine, I'll go.
Minas Ithil is on Gondor's frontier, so we have few occasions for the grand balls and masquerades that are surely common events in the capital city. Fine dresses like this one are worn for ceremony, funerals and weddings mostly, not for lordly entertainment. I wonder if the noble families of Minas Tirith spared a thought for us, holding all of Mordor at bay while they danced.
Kill you!
it just moved.
You won't give me a
Gondorians, this midnight urn is a simple pot of clay, but to the denizens of Minas Ithil, it represented shared sacrifice that only those who live on the frontier understand. For centuries, the name of every able-bodied resident of Minas Ithil was placed in the midnight urn, and at sunset, a name was drawn. That person would have to patrol the city's walls until sunrise. The task was ceremonial once we had a professional army. But that made it no less important. From our earliest days, it was always a neighbor watching from the walls. I was 10 the first time they drew my name, and I've never been prouder, though I could barely see over the parapet.
Just... Shock.
You die. Can I have... Oh.
This executioner has more to fear than the condemned do.
I've lopped off lots of heads, but I never had someone volunteer for execution before. Justice demands you die!
It's the dark! Cover my retreat!
The sentence? You'll feel this one!
did for supper! It's so cold.
Marku.
Earliest memories are of being nestled under blankets as my mother showed me the illustrations in a storybook about Luki the Larrikin, whose mischief always ended in disaster, though she was always one step ahead of her stern governess. I found the book tucked away years later after I learned to read, and I was surprised to learn that the storybook was full of little morality plays, not the comic tales my mother told. I wonder why she did that.
You've sent someone to spy on us. I just know it. Mark my words. I'll find him and make him pay.
The distant north have long been named among Gondor's allies, though I've never seen one in person. This cloak is as light as the morning fog on the shoulders. I tried it on once, and its colors seem to shift and blend as the light changes. How meager the product of our looms is when compared to elven handiwork.
way! I smell stuff! Get him off the base! Caragor! I'm right behind you! Back up! You should be in a cage! Get the others!
That's it, lads. Tire him out and tenderize him a bit. The show's about to start.
Men and orcs have clashed for centuries. In living memory, the greatest battle between them took place near Long Lake, where men, aided by elves and dwarves, battled the orcs and goblins of Moria. The free folk won the day, and some accounts claim that eagles of the Misty Mountains swooped down onto the battlefield, casting the orcs down from the cliffs and mountains where they stood. Seems a fanciful tale. I saw no eagles overhead when Minas Ithil fell, though we did have Talion and his strange powers. We would have welcomed aid from anywhere, even the skies.
Have you ever seen a spider's web strung with dew? That is the web of fate. All possibilities hang in the balance. But as the sun rises and the wind blows, the dewdrops fall, and history is revealed. A dark lord or a bright one? Middle-earth will have neither. I will shake the branch until all have fallen.
Praetorians are fighting a war they've already lost.
Are neither the only denizens of Mordor, nor the first. Easterlings and Haradrim have settled here from time to time, often at the Dark Lord's invitation. They are scarce today, but one can still find their strange artistic carvings scattered in places from Nern to the city of the Corsairs.
Just here.